this country, you got to make the money first. Then when you get the money, you get the power. Then when you get the power, then you get the woman.
What up, everybody? How you doing? You're here kicking it with Mr. P. I am your host, Mr. Paraguay 12. Okay, so this is pretty much my Super Bowl talk. I wanted to get into, you know, who's going to the Super Bowl, who's not going to the Super Bowl, and, you know, Richard Sherman's little speech. But let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so as you know, the Denver Broncos and the Seattle Seahawks are going to the Super Bowl. Congratulations to you both. You are phenomenal teams. I cannot wait. I am super excited for this year's Super Bowl. Now, I, from the beginning, called the Denver Broncos going to the Super Bowl. I said they were going all the way. I remember watching the first couple of games at the beginning of the season. I was like, man, Peyton is on fire. He is going all the way. This is his year. I mean, what a phenomenal year he's had. I mean, just to come back from his injury, getting let go from the Colts, and just coming back with, like, ferocious feeling and just like, you know what, this is my time. He's super focused. I mean, the guy broke so many records this year and he just cannot lose. I mean, this guy is a phenomenal quarterback and what he did for the Colts was amazing. But this year, I think by far was one of his best years I've ever seen. I know he's gonna get the MVP, and if he doesn't, man, that's just a sad day in sports. Now, I had to work Sunday, so I didn't catch the first half of the Denver versus Pats game, but I did catch the second and it was a beatdown. I mean, at one point it was like 26-3. I mean, Tom Brady, I mean, he's a good quarterback. He just could not get his receivers. I mean, he was overthrowing every ball. You could tell he wasn't focused. I mean, his offensive line wasn't there, his defensive line wasn't there. And then they wanted to wake up at like the last quarter, and it's like, yo, you can't wake up from a sleep and then just expect to win the last quarter. You can't do that. The game was already lost, in my opinion, by the third quarter. It was just a beatdown. But congratulations to the Denver Broncos. They did win that game. They are headed to the Super Bowl. Now, I had a bunch of people over for the 49ers Seahawks game. I was super excited about this game. I could not wait to see this. I knew it was going to be a clash of the Titans. A few weeks back, I did call the Seattle Seahawks to go to at least the Super Bowl. Like I said, I did call Denver to win it all. The game was pretty good. It kind of started off a little slow. It was leaning towards the Niners winning, but then it's all of a sudden like Russell Wilson and his team just woke up and they started murdering the Niners. I mean, they just could not do anything. And they ultimately got the win and they are headed to the Super Bowl. Congratulations to you guys. Now, one of the big things that's going on right now in sports and all around the news is Richard Sherman's speech when he got interviewed. Now, if you don't know what the interview was, you should. But if you don't, I'll put a link in the description down below and show you guys what the interview was. I mean, it was just crazy. I mean, he got on the mic and was just, you know, yelling like, I'm the best corner in the league. You can't stop me. You know, just pretty much bragging. Now, in my opinion, it wasn't a very smart thing to do. And I'm going to go ahead and give you guys my thoughts on the situation right now. So some of the things he said may or may have not been true. That's really not the debate here. My opinion is whether or not he should have even said those things on live TV in front of millions and millions of people. Now you can sit here and say football's an emotional game, you know, now it's all for sissies, we should see more of that stuff. In my opinion, that may be true, but he shouldn't have said those things on national TV. I mean, you could tell that he was fired up. And, you know, he was excited. He was just, you know, still in the heat of the moment. And that's understandable. You can say those things when you're not on TV. It's okay. But when you're in front of millions of people, it's a little different. You're not only showing the public their perception of you, but you're showing the perception of your team also, your company, the people you play for, your city. And some people are turning this into a racial thing. I don't think it's a racial thing at all. It's not at all a racial thing. That's not what this is for. This is for he's a person. I don't see color of the skin, so that shouldn't even be remotely near the conversation. It was very classless. He shouldn't have said it, and it should have been kept at least to himself. Now, the interviewer that was interviewing him, I think she saw an opportunity to take it, and she was in the corner like, look, oh, he's getting angry. Let's go ahead and interview him and see what he says. And towards the end of the interview, she was like gonna try to say some more things to interview him, and I think she just got cut off. She was like, oh, and by the, oh, on to you, back to you, whatever. You know, he kind of got cut short. I think they cut it short on purpose, and it was kind of smart that they cut it short because he was getting a little out of control. But like I said, it is football. There's a lot of motion in it. So next time, maybe you shouldn't interview him. I can't wait to see what he can do going forward. It was a phenomenal play that he did when he batted away the pass and it came to an interception. I mean, it saved the game. The things that he said had nothing to do with the play. The play spoke for itself, and that's what I think he should have did. Let his play speak for himself, and let all the other extra stuff, leave it alone. Now, if you were to ask me right now who's headed to the Super Bowl, I don't know. I'm going to have to say the Denver Broncos. I mean, Peyton, you cannot stop him. I mean, he is having a phenomenal year. This is his year. He is going to win. Russell Wilson is a phenomenal quarterback, but he's still a little bit inexperienced. Peyton, on the other hand, is just a phenomenal quarterback, very experienced, has been in the league for a very long time, and in my opinion, I think he will take the Super Bowl ring home. Now, as you know, the Super Bowl is in 2 weeks, February 2nd. I will be watching it. Now, the only shitty thing for me is on the Thursday before, I have to get my wisdom teeth taken out. I've been in a lot of pain the last few weeks. It's been hurting me like crazy. I'm getting all four of my wisdom teeth taken out. So I'm thinking about I might not be able to have people over because I may not be good all the way through till Sunday, but I'm hoping I will be. And I'm not trying to be a baby or nothing, but I know it's going to hurt, so I guess we'll see how that goes. I just can't wait to get them out and have this pain go away, man. It's been killing me. But for now, everybody take care. I can't wait to see the Super Bowl. I know it's going to be exciting. And to whoever wins, good luck to both the teams. I'll talk to everybody soon. Peace.